In the last video, I introduced to you the concept of the Fourier series of a periodic function of period 2L. This was the Fourier series here, an infinite series of cosine and sines. You can view these as a linear superposition of waves of various frequencies. Using orthogonality relations, I showed you how you can derive these coefficients in terms of integrals over these functions. So this is the full Fourier series of some function. Sometimes the function has some symmetry, which allows us to eliminate either the sine term or the cosine term in this series. Those resulting series are called the Fourier sine or the Fourier cosine series. So the symmetry has to do with whether the function is even or odd. What is an even function? If we look at, say, f of minus x equals f of x, meaning that the function is the same when you reflect it about the y-axis, this is called even. And the Fourier series will then simplify. If you have an even function in this expression for the b coefficients, if you have an even function times an odd function, sine is an odd function, and you integrate that over an interval minus L to L, you will get zero. So this an even function times an odd function is an odd function, and the integral of an odd function across symmetrically across the y-axis gives you zero. So the b's in this case will be zero, and then we end up with the Fourier cosine series. So we'll get f of x then is simply a naught over 2 plus the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of a sub n cosine n pi x over L. And these a coefficients we can simplify slightly. So now f is even. Cosine is an even function. So an even function times an even function is an even function. And then instead of integrating from minus L to L, we can integrate from 0 to L and multiply the integral by 2. So we get a sub n equals 2 over L times the integral from 0 to L of f of x cosine n pi x over L dx. And this is called the Fourier cosine series. The other symmetry case is when f of minus x equals minus f of x. This is the odd, the case of an odd function. The same sort of arguments will hold here. So here the a sub n comes from integrating an odd function times an even function. An odd function times an even function is odd. And the integral across symmetrically across the y-axis here, minus L to L, will give you 0. So here the a's are all 0, and all you have left are the b's. So in this case, f of x is the summation from n equals 1 to infinity of b sub n sine n pi x over L. And in a similar way, the b sub n is equal to 2 over L times the integral from 0 to L of f of x sine n pi x over L dx. Okay, so let me review. The general Fourier series sometimes simplifies into a Fourier sine series or a Fourier cosine series. If f is an even function of x, then you get the Fourier cosine series. The only information you need about that function is over half of its periodic interval, here from 0 to L. F is periodic over 2L. Similarly, if the function is an odd function of x, then the complete Fourier series simplifies into a Fourier sine series with a corresponding integral. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.